Good morning from Plattsburgh, New York. What's going on here? I'm Bob Venn, and this smiling lady who's glad we're here is Amy Whitehead. And Amy, your title?
I'm the executive director.
Of the Plattsburgh and Clinton County?
Chamber of Commerce. Right. You got it, Bob.
Does that mean there's two or there's only one?
There's only one Chamber of Commerce. It just means that we are a countywide Chamber of Commerce, but because Plattsburgh is the largest city in the area that is most recognized outside of the county, we've kept that name with us.
You say kept it, that means mm-hmm. you must have been here before. Mm-hmm. It was the Plattsburgh Chamber before?
Right. The Chamber started in 1912. We're just about ready to celebrate our 80th anniversary, and started out as the Plattsburgh Chamber of Commerce, and then we changed our name and became a county chamber in the late 70s, early 80s, is making the transition.
Okay. Does that mean you draw your members from throughout the county?
We draw our membership from throughout the county. We also have members from Vermont, and we also have members from southern Quebec as well as outside in the tri-county area. So we're larger than the county, but primarily the issues that we deal with are Clinton County issues, as well as the bulk of our membership are also from Clinton County.
The bulk? Well, do we have people mm-hmm. from outside the county who belong?
Oh, yes. We've got a membership of right about 1,000 members, and of that, there are probably 100 to 150 of those members are outside of Clinton County in terms of where their primary business is.
Essex and Franklin we're talking about?
Essex, Franklin, Vermont, Quebec.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
yes.
I didn't realize you went that far.
Oh, yes.
All right. Now, how many other chambers are there within the county of Clinton? Can you
within
tell
the
that?
County, there are three chambers. There is our Chamber of Commerce, which is located here in Plattsburgh, but does serve the entire county. There's also the Northern Tier Chamber of Commerce, which covers the Northern Tier areas of everywhere from Chazy to Rouses Point, Champlain, Moores. And then there's also a Chamber of Commerce in Keysville.
Okay. Can the members who belong to the Northern Tier or the Southern Tier also belong here?
Oh, yes. We have many members who are members of either both or all three organizations.
Why would I do that? Why would I be with all three?
Because the chambers offer different things. Our Chamber of Commerce, because we are the largest organization, offers countywide information. We deal with issues that have to do everything with government affairs on wetlands and natural gas projects to issues that deal on the whole county, economic development, tourism. Those are countywide levels that this organization primarily focuses on. Then you've got the Northern Tier Chamber, who is more of a regional chamber. They deal with the Northern Tier issues, which we may or may not get involved in, depending on its impact on the entire county. So the other chambers are more localized, and we're much broader. So what happens is a lot of businesses will be members of those other organizations, but then look to us for that larger umbrella.
Do you have to be a business person to be the chamber?
We have a lot of individuals, professional individuals, as well as members, or as well as businesses. The bulk of our membership are businesses, though. There are a few individuals that do remain members.
Okay. We're located, we're on North Margaret Street, if you could call it mm-hmm. that, just north of the Georgia Pacific. Is it, we still Georgia
just
Pacific?
North, just north, north of Georgia Pacific.
On the mm-hmm. lakeside.
In West Bay Plaza.
In West Bay Plaza. Yes. And a number here? Is there a number?
350 Margaret Street, P.O. Box 310 for mailing addresses.
Well, all right. We're in behind what may be one of your chamber members, I guess, the hangar.
Yes.
Right?
The movie hangar.
The movie
which
hangar.
Which is in
up.
West Bay Plaza.
All right. Mm-hmm. Why would anybody want to belong to a Chamber of Commerce? What do you do for, mm-hmm. let's say Hometown Cable. Why would they want to belong if they wanted to belong?
There are a lot of different reasons to belong. But the ultimate reason that I think really drives a Chamber of Commerce from when they were conceived way back, you know, hundreds of years ago, the thing is that as an individual business owner or business person, there are a lot of things that you deal with on a day-to-day basis. You have to deal with making payroll, of looking at the marketing of your business, of getting everything working together, making sure that your supply is there, making sure that the demand, and you're working with all of these. And what happens is in the day-to-day, most businesses stay within themselves, and that they are working so hard to keep, you know, themselves going, and that all of a sudden when there is a governmental issue or there is an economic or a community issue that comes down, it's very difficult as an individual to make things happen. What the Chamber of Commerce does is bring all of these people together and makes things happen on a very broad scale. Makes things happen in terms of developing economic development, countywide tourism programs, developing programs to deal with governmental intervention in business in terms of whether it's a wetland situation or whether it's trying to get natural gas. It is an organization that by being a part of it, you are supporting the development of the community as a whole, which as an individual, you may not be able to do as effectively.
Okay, now, even though I'm an individual, don't have a business, I could profit a lot from what you just told me, even though I don't belong.
Yes.
You're not working only for business people.
That's true.
You're working for the common citizens.
We are working, the chambers of the 90s are working for the entire community. It used to be, if you go back and look in the 1960s or 70s or, you know, years past, chambers of commerce worked just for business, and it was only business issues. Now what is happening is it's working for the entire community. And it is a situation where we have a responsibility to working within the community that we're located and giving something back to it. And that may sound altruistic on one level, but the other side is that the returns of that really do affect my bottom line, affect my pocket, as well as the quality of life within the community that we live in.
Amy, I'm familiar with the county, and I don't remember ever hearing Whitehead as a local name. Are you from this area?
No, I'm not. No, I'm not.
You want to give us where you are from? Or?
I grew up in a small town in western Nebraska. Lived in the same house the whole, you know, until I graduated from high school. Didn't move or live anyplace else. And then after that, I lived in Wyoming, getting my undergraduate degree. I went to 2 years at the University of Wyoming. From there, finished my degree at Arizona State University in public relations and marketing. I worked there for a year in the Phoenix area. And then I moved to Minnesota to get my graduate degree. And after that, I started in the shopping center development industry. Lived in Des Moines, Iowa, and worked in a home office for a corporation there. Lived in Colorado Springs, and then moved from Colorado Springs to here. I was an import in 1987 with the Pyramid companies.
Okay, you came with Pyramid. Did you work for Pyramid before they came here?
No, I was recruited by Pyramid to come here and open their new malls.
Okay. You like the area?
Oh, I love the area.
You love the area?
I love the area. I've been here for 5 years now.
Does it stand up well with all the other places you've lived?
It does. When you look at this area, the amount of natural resources and just natural beauty that we have here far surpasses other communities. There's so much opportunity here with everything from Montreal being close to Burlington and to our own uniqueness within our community. It's a wonderful place to live.
When I think of Nebraska, am I right when I say Broken Bow?
Oh,
is there a Broken
Bow?
Now, that's a great name, isn't it? Broken Bow, Nebraska?
Yes. There is a Broken Bow, Nebraska, yes, and I've been there.
You have been there?
Oh, yes. I was from far western Nebraska. And yes, I do have Cornhusker blood. It does flow Cornhusker red. We used to have season tickets, and we would go to the Nebraska Cornhusker games, and I'm also. And I don't believe I'm going to admit this on camera, I'm a Denver Bronco fan also.
Oh, well, I'm sorry you just did here. There any others at Plattsburgh?
Very few. Well, at least not ones that will publicly admit it. So.
Well, for your team, you win a lot of games, but you don't seem to win the big one.
You
haven't won the big one.
It'll come.
At least you have sometimes a much better season than we Giants did during the year, right?
Well, I wasn't going to mention that, but I also don't want you to mention a Super Bowl fairly recently.
We'll just pass
on that topic.
Except I remember the Giants and the Denver met in a Super Bowl one time, as you recall.
Yes, and that's why I don't want to talk about it.
All right.
That
could have gone the other way,
first,
you know.
The first of a series of football of Super Bowls that the Broncos lost.
How long have you been at this location, and where were you before?
The Chamber of Commerce has been located here for almost 5 years. It relocated here in 1986. Before that, we were located in the county courthouse in the downtown area. The decision to move here was primarily one of space and one of developing a professional image. The organization moved here 5-6 years ago, and we do own the facility here. And
you own the building?
Yes. Well, not the entire building. We just own. It's a condo.
Okay,
we
own this section.
We have 2,000 square feet here.
Okay. I know there was some talk back in the paper when I think about that, about whether you should move out of the mm-hmm. center community. How's that worked out?
Mm-hmm. I think it's worked out very well. It was a very controversial decision, and it was done before I was with the organization. But I think overall, the move has given the organization a professional image and has really pulled them to another level. The organization, if you go back and look at how we've evolved, as I said a little earlier, we started off as a downtown chamber of commerce, primarily a merchants association, evolved in the 60s and 70s to more interest in tourism. In 1979, we did merge with another tourist bureau who was available or who was in the market at that time. So we combined the two and really got involved in tourism issues, and that's where a lot of our focus was. You may remember the hot air ballooning and the air shows and things like that. The chamber then, in the early 80s, made the conscious decision that we need to be a business organization. We still need to be looking at the tourism issues, because that is one of the major industries here in Clinton County, but we also needed to be responsive to other business issues. After all, we are the largest business organization in the county, and we need to speak towards business issues. As a result of that change in philosophy, per se, if you'd like to call it that, we've really gotten involved in everything from community development issues, economic development issues, including tourism, as well as larger, broader economic development issues, such as going up to Montreal, exhibiting in their trade shows, and trying to recruit businesses down to this area and support the agencies that do that on the front lines, getting involved in governmental issues. Everything from Lake Champlain Management Conference issues to natural gas, bringing natural gas here into this market through the Falcon Seaboard pipeline, as well as the most recent issue of the wetlands.
As you probably see, I'm having trouble breathing this morning, so we're going to take a short break. We're going to find out when we get back the officers of this Plattsburgh Chamber of Commerce. I assume there are some. Mm-hmm. And also maybe some of the main things that they cover. Maybe we'll talk about some other people we'll meet here in your office. We'll be right back. You're watching Hometown Cable, Plattsburgh and Clinton County Chamber of Commerce. Amy Whitehead is the smiling lady that doesn't seem to have any problem at all in telling us all about the chamber. She knows her subject, and she loved her job. I can tell that mm-hmm. already.
Oh, definitely.
Be right back. Well, I hope you're still with us, and please don't go away. You'll notice we've got comfortable. Now we're sitting down. It means we're going to be here a while. And we were mentioning, as we're talking with Amy Whitehead, we're going to find out who belongs, not who belongs, but your executive group, how many employees you have, and what they do, et cetera.
Mm-hmm. Our Chamber of Commerce is governed by the Board of Directors. They are the decision-making group for the organization. They are nominated on an annual basis and serve three-year terms. This year, our president of the board is Herb Carpenter of Northeast Printing Companies. Our incoming vice president is Mark Berry of the Champlain Development Corp in Rouse's Point. Then we also have the executive committee, and the members of the executive committee are also heads of our divisions. Our Chamber of Commerce is divided into four divisions. One is the Government Affairs Division, which is chaired and headed up by Joe Curtis of Georgia Pacific. Our Community Development Division is headed up by Mike Mannix of United Way. Our Economic Development Division is headed up by Dave Meath of Buck Paper. And then our Organizational Development Division is headed up by Vicki Duffett. And so we've got those people on the executive committee, as well as our treasurer, who is John Purley of Champlain National Bank, and then I also serve on the executive committee. So that is the group within the executive committee, and then the larger board sets the policy. After the board sets a policy, then it's up to us as staff, as well as working with the volunteers, to get the projects, programs developed and produced for our membership.
Okay, how many employees do you have?
Here we've got... It's hard to say. We've really got eight people working with us. But of those, there are six that are full-time. There is one person, Claire Guineau, and all that she does is, which isn't a minor task, she goes to all of our meetings and transcribes all of the minutes. So she's very, very busy, but is not a full-time position. And then we also have a part-time receptionist, Shirley Abraham, who is with us in the afternoon and works very diligently in answering tourism requests, informational requests, as well as dealing with the tourists that do come into our office.
So you are hired by the executive board?
By the entire board.
By the entire
mm-hmm.
board.
Yes.
Hires you. Then you, in turn, hire the employees
right.
in here.
Right.
Or fire, whatever, right?
Mm-hmm.
You, All right. Now, you went from marketing mm-hmm. at Pyramid.
Yes.
And you came to the chamber. As Pyramid, were you also part of the chamber at that time?
I was a member. When I was with the Pyramid Companies, I was a member of the tourism board and was active in that part. So when I did come on as a staff person here, I did have some exposure, but again, it was a limited exposure to the chamber through the tourism route. And what you learn very quickly here is there are many facets to the program, which is, you know, when people ask what is the chamber involved in and how do you describe it, it's incredible because there's a very large number of programs that we're involved in, and oftentimes people will see one or two segments, and as long as that is meeting their needs, that's terrific.
Would you believe that I wrote to a place called Scott's Bluff, Nebraska, and asked if they knew who Amy Whitehead was? And that they told me that...
Would I believe you?
Would you believe me if I told you that?
Probably.
Okay. Would you believe that they told me that you were a... debating and public speaking?
You did call them, didn't you?
When you were there?
Research, yes.
You would believe that?
Mm-hmm.
And that this was not probably in your future ever. You never thought of being in a Chamber of Commerce.
No,
you were
I
into marketing?
Mm-hmm.
All right. I didn't do any of that. But I did read a very nice article about you that I happen to have at home mm-hmm. in Strictly Business. Written
yes.
by Mr. Carpenter, not yes. Mr. Carpenter, but in one of his magazines.
That was their first publication.
Was it? Well, all right. I happen to have their
first.
Honor
to be the first
cover
article.
Yes, it was.
Article,
You're
yes.
on the cover, too.
Yes.
So I didn't really write to them, but it just as well I mm-hmm. could have written, all right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So how did it come about that you left Pyramid to come here?
It was a situation where the former director here, Rosalind Leahy, her husband was transferred out of the area, so it became known that they were moving to Florida. And the position came open. And it was one that had always intrigued me. With one of the things that I enjoy so much about it is the multifaceted perspective of that. I am one of those people who I love to get in with a project, and I'm a fairly quick learner, and I'll figure out where things are going fairly quickly. But the worst thing you could do is put me on an assembly line. I would go absolutely nuts if I had to do the same thing over and over and over and just uh-huh. pushing paper. That's not the type of job that would interest me, which is why I've always enjoyed marketing. And so when this position came up, I was very interested in the challenge and enjoy a challenge. And that has certainly been the case since I've taken on this job.
Well, marketing, you're into marketing when you get into Chamber of Commerce.
Yes.
Is that a type of marketing?
It's a piece. What I have found is you come in with your own preconceptions as to what it's going to all be about and where the focus is going to be and how, you know, what type of attributes you need for the position. And I found that I've been here now for about 3.5 years, and it continues to evolve. And I found that marketing is one facet, and that what I need to do is hire people who can do the marketing and then oversee that, and it's much more of a management leadership role than a marketing or an administrative role per se.
Okay, now, when I think of the Chamber of Commerce, I think of... tourist information,
mm-hmm.
a tourist booth,
mm-hmm.
and paying dues.
Mm-hmm.
That's it,
mm-hmm.
as an individual.
It's interesting because one of the good things about working in the chamber industry is that you can be anywhere in the United States and probably anywhere across the country, and you say Chamber of Commerce, and automatically someone has an idea of what a chamber is. But that's also one of the hindrances, because I can be in a smaller community, and I may have a concept of what a chamber is, and I may move to another area, and it will be something totally different. And so the chambers of commerce are very different in different communities. What our chamber does here, 10 years ago, 20 years ago, we were primarily a tourist information and a supplier of information to tourists coming into the area, as well as marketing tourist industries here. We're much broader than that now. We're much broader in terms of looking at the community as a whole, recognizing that the tourism sector is a very important sector within our economy, our local economy, but it is one facet. And we need to be looking at those other areas and how can we make it so that business that exists in Clinton County is as strong as it can be, which means strong in terms of making sure that there aren't undue governmental influences on it, making sure that it is strong as it can be in terms of knowledge and skills and learning through whether it's seminars that we provide or bringing in speakers and educational programs, to taking it to the other extreme of making sure that the community here is meeting their needs in terms of quality of life issues. That's how broad a chamber is. And it makes it harder to market because there are so many different things that you're involved in. But I also think that it makes the organization much stronger than it was 5, 10, 20, 50 years ago.
If you saw our show on WCFE, you'll know that when you do a TV show, they sometimes have teleprompters, which help people to figure out what they're going to say next. I want to assure you that this lady has no teleprompter here, and she knows her subject real, real well.
I'm putting on my sleeve.
If I only do the right, I don't have to worry about questions either here. You really are eating this right up, I can tell. You love your job. Mm-hmm. So are you out speaking a lot, Amy?
I do. I go out anytime I'm offered, as long as it fits into my schedule, which is interesting because when I was working at the mall, my weeks would be 7 days a week. Working on the weekends. And one of the things I've enjoyed about this job is I now suddenly have weekends, but my days, a typical day for me will start at 7 or 7:30. It even starts
at home or here?
Here, in the office.
All right.
Oftentimes it'll start as early as 6:30.
Is that right?
And I'm not a morning person, so that's amazing. But I usually am here at about 7, 7:30, as late as 8 some days, and I'm usually here until 6, or if I have a dinner. So my days are very long Monday through Friday, but the weekends are all mine. So
that's a long day. All right. We're going to talk to some of your other employees. What are some of the things that you have done, say, the past 6 months or been involved in that we all know about from reading in the paper but we've forgotten? All right, what have you got for the next 6 months you can think of quickly?
Oh, quickly. In terms of activities, we have next week our business trade show, which is the largest business trade show north of Albany. We have more than 100 exhibitors. We have approximately 50 Canadians coming down to a how-to-do-business seminar in, how-to-do-business in the United States seminar. So we're bringing Canadians down, we're bringing local business representatives out, and we're going to have a wonderful day of doing business in northern New York. So that is a major focus on March 18th.
And can anybody go to that public?
Where
is it going to be held? Where?
It's going to be at the Field House, the SUNY Plattsburgh Field House.
Right.
It is from 11 to 7 p.m. Stop by any time during the day. The exhibitors will be set up, and I think it's going to be absolutely terrific. It's our fourth annual, and every year it gets bigger and bigger and better, and it's been terrific. The people here on staff working on it have been our associate director, Robin Albert, and then we have worked with Mike Cavanaugh, who was hired for just this project. He has done a terrific job of selling the booze. Our trade show committee, under the leadership of Dick Johnson, has been absolutely fabulous, and it's terrific. Other activities were involved in everything.
If I can interrupt you here just a minute. What would the public see if they went out there? What are we going to see?
What they're going to see are local businesses as well as businesses from Vermont, the Tri-County area, and a few Canadian exhibitors who have set up their booths who are going to show what their products are. One of the things that prompted this entire trade show was oftentimes we're looking, and in business, we're looking for a widget. We need a supplier of a certain widget. So what we do is we get on the phone, find a supplier out in Ohio. And about a year later, someone will mention, oh, well, I buy that down the street. And oftentimes, we don't know what is in our own backyard. So the concept and the original purpose of the show is to showcase those businesses that are here in Clinton County so that we know what opportunities are here and to do business within our own market. Because every time we turn that dollar over within our own market and don't go outside, it makes it go much, much farther in terms of helping our economy. So that's how it started. Now what people will see attending the show is everything from a corporation like a Platco, who can talk about what they're doing on an international level in terms of selling dust valves, which is a very unique, it used to be the foundry, and everyone still thinks of the company as the foundry, but it's so much broader than that, to local office suppliers. Plattsburgh Office Systems will be there with all of their copiers, everything. It's the entire gamut of what you've got available in Clinton County.
Okay, I didn't mean to interrupt you there, I want to make sure that they do. All right, and other things you were going to mention? Something.
Other projects that I think most people are fairly aware of that we're involved in, I'll name three, the big ones that we're involved in the last 6 months. First and foremost is we're very active in the Team Plattsburgh effort, which is dealing with the Plattsburgh Air Force Base situation. We just had Congressman Martin out for breakfast this last weekend and did a strategy session with him and are continuing to develop strategies that... The idea behind the entire program is to make sure that the Plattsburgh story is told and that the Plattsburgh Air Force Base is optimized. And once it is optimized, then we feel that any time they go through a base closure situation, they will understand the benefits of this base and that we will remain an open base. There will be a closure commission next year at this time, so we have 1 year to pull those efforts together. And that is being spearheaded by the leadership of Herb Carpenter, our president this year, but is a true community effort in terms of bringing together the Airbase Liaison Committee, bringing together the governmental officials. All facets of this county are being brought together in that effort. Another effort that we're very active in is our governmental affairs issue, which is currently dealing with the wetlands remapping of Clinton County. As you know, we were just remapped for wetlands. The Department of Environmental Conservation unveiled their maps in June. It added approximately 300% to the amount of wetlands of the area outside of the park. What we are trying to do and what the Chamber's position has been, we feel that we do need to look at the wetlands in terms of preservation of actual wetlands, but we want to make sure that if these maps are going to be finalized, that they are as accurate as possible, and that every landowner understands the implications and understands what their rights are in terms of asking the Department of Environmental Conservation to come out and look at their property and show them where those wetlands are. So it's an educational process.
Okay, that would be the last thing I thought you'd be involved in as a chamber. No. How did you get involved in that?
We got involved in that primarily because in looking at the entire Clinton community, you know, you look at the entire county area, and what issues impact that? If you look at the wetlands issue, on one level, people will say, why is a chamber involved in that? Because if you're a business, most of the businesses that are affected have the money. They can hire their, environmental attorneys, they can hire their land surveyors, they can hire all those people to go out and fight with the departments. But when we looked at it, who is being left out of that? Who does not have the money and the abilities to be able to do that? Small businesses, who is our primary member of our organization, and individuals. And we felt that as a county, that the amount of wetlands that have been mapped in this county, 15% of the entire county area is mapped as wetlands. And when you have that amount of land being taken off of the tax rolls, you're going to have some major changing in this area in terms of the tax dollars that are coming into the county and into the town governments through property taxes. You're looking at some very major ramifications that most people haven't looked at. And we made the choice. You can either go in and say something and do something about it by educating people, or let it happen. And we didn't want this to be one of those gotcha things that sneaks up and gets you when you aren't looking.
Now, we don't often think of farmers as a businessman, but certainly they are. So are they also members of your chamber? Do you have many? And if you aren't already, you ought to think about this, because the chamber is doing a great job on these wetlands. I know people up north are very upset. And you can't use the land at all, I understand.
Oh, you look at the town of Clinton and the amount of wetlands mapped. I wish I had a map here that you could look. It is almost entirely wetlands. It's not 100, but it's probably about 40 to 50% of that
terrible.
Entire town
right.
is mapped. And that means, depending on the classification of those wetlands, that land may now be deemed unuseful or unusable, which now means, what do you do with it if you own it? Why do you pay taxes on it, and why have you paid taxes on it if you can never develop on it? So there are incredible ramifications, and it was an issue that we looked at long and hard as to, is this an issue that is appropriate for the chamber to be involved in? And we looked at it finally and said, we cannot afford not to be involved in it. We have to, because if we don't do it, no one else out there is going to do it. It is going to happen. The wetland maps, if we wouldn't have gotten involved, would have been finalized probably about 3 months ago. And at this point, we're still working with the Department of Environmental Conservation and working with the landowners, hoping that their request, their information is met, so that when they are finally signed off on, everyone will have had their chance, their day in court, if you want to call it that, to ask the questions and find out the implications.
Irishman of the Year, are you involved?
Oh.
Are you involved in that?
Oh. And I wish I had an Irish accent, because I don't. And I'm not even wearing green today. Oh, yes.
You're early. Got a week to go.
Oh, let me tell you, we have a great program. We are changing it ever so slightly this year. And the only way we're changing it is we have so many giveaways. This community has opened up its arms, and we have some great giveaways. Everything from the actual Blarney Stone that I believe we will be giving away, or at least a piece of the Blarney Stone and a little Blarney to go with it, to we've got cases of Killian's beer, we've got what's that Irish Don't know my alcohols, Shamrock. Do I? Anyway, we've got so many giveaways that the whole community has just, they keep giving us all this terrific
stuff. You just give it
stuff.
To everybody, or do you,
well,
you draw numbers?
What happens is anyone that attends a breakfast is going to get, it comes with the ticket. When you buy your ticket to come to the breakfast, you get a card. You get your number. And throughout the entire breakfast, we're going to be drawing and having a ton of giveaways. We've got probably 30 or 40 giveaways, and these are very nice. Very nice.
All right. What is the Citizen of the Year? That's the 17th? Makes sense if it
yes,
is.
Yes. It's
right.
St. Patty's Day.
It's and it's
at
where?
The SUNY Plattsburgh Ballroom.
Okay.
And it starts at bright at 8 a.m. And I was thinking of Bailey's Irish Cream.
All right.
Oh, yes.
And how many people do you expect at a breakfast like this?
We usually have about 300 to 400 people. And we still have, it's a first-come, first-served basis. We still have some seats available. So if you're interested, call the chamber right away, because it fills up quick.
Well, as you know, they aren't always Irish who become the Irishman of the year.
Oh, but they all wish they were Irish.
They will wish they were Irish, mm-hmm. Right. Well, and they have...
And this year, our Irishman of the Year will be very special.
You know already?
Oh,
oh
yes.
Ho, ho.
The committee has already chosen the designated Irish...
And you know...
Oh, I know.
That means that you're not going to be the Irishman of the Year. We know
oh,
that. We know that,
that,
right?
Oh, okay. I know that.
Okay.
My name is too English to get me in.
Well, you never know. there are some other people that were, Bornstein? He was one of the early ones, right?
Mick Bornstein?
I'm sorry. Mick Bornstein was real early.
Oh, yes, he was the first Irishman of the Year.
He was the first?
Yes.
He was the first. Well-deserved. Did an awful lot for the area.
Oh, yes.
Mr. Toastmaster of our county, I guess
yes.
you'd say. All right. Who else can we... we'll go in and talk to somebody else. We'll get back to you later. Let you
Sounds
do some
good.
Of your other things. Who else are we going to see?
I think what we'll do is we'll first start off with Steve Oakley.
Okay.
Steve is our membership services manager. He is the person out on the front lines who is dealing one-on-one with our membership, talking to them about either joining the Chamber of Commerce or getting active in the Chamber. He is our personal face that you put to the Chamber of Commerce who's out in the community. We'll talk a little bit with some of the other staff people who can talk more about what their specific job responsibilities are. And through talking to them, I'm sure you'll see the broader picture of what the Chamber's all about.
Okay. From Nebraska, Amy Whitehead. And now a resident of our quality of life, Clinton County, Plattsburgh area. And we're going to be talking with someone else, and thank you very much for watching. Hometown Cable programs called What's Going On Here. Calvin Kastein behind the camera. Bob Venn here with a stuffed-up head this morning. And please, I thank you for bearing with me. We hope we're better off by the next show we have. Thank you very much, Amy. We'll be right back. It's a smiling office they have here. This smiling gentleman right here is Steve Oakley. And, of course, the first question always is, obviously... I knew your aunt, Annie, was she your aunt, Annie Oakley?
To be honest, Annie Oakley was not my aunt. No relation at all. And
no.
I've been told that I do shoot from the hip.
All right. Steve, where are you from? Are you from this area?
Yes, I am. I grew up in West Jersey, and 1973 graduate of Beekmantown High School. Great place to grow up. Super area. Climbed a lot in the Adirondacks, very involved in sports. Baseball, football especially.
Farming family? Were you a farmer?
No. Oh. My dad is now a retired teacher from Beekmantown. He taught there 29 years. My mother was born and raised in West Jersey and just celebrated, I believe it's her 21st anniversary with the USPO, the post office. My grandparents, Morris, Mary, and Lucia, were from West Jersey. My dad's from around Hyde Park, Poughkeepsie area. And since he graduated from Plattsburgh, he's been up this area a long time.
Very natural. You're working right here in Plattsburgh then.
It's good being back after I'd been away for 14 years. After I'd graduated from Ithaca College, I had a chance to still play professional baseball or go to work for Procter & Gamble. So I went into sales and marketing, which has been my profession ever since I graduated in May of 77.
Oh, well, now we got to take a break here in a way. We're not with the camera, but baseball. Continue professional baseball. That means you played some professional baseball?
Well, I had a couple tryouts. I should qualify that.
Okay.
I had a tryout way back when. That tells you how almost ancient I am with the Expos when they played at Jerry Park. It was a tryout in the summer of 73, if memory serves me correctly. And also with the Pirates, matter of fact, Danny Murtaugh was then manager, and he was up in the stands at the old Bailey Avenue. So that was my stint. I did still have teams contacting me while I was at college during my senior
year. Pitcher or catcher?
I got a little tired of pitching. Pitched for the post 20 team a lot in high school and right up through the ranks, the progression, Babe Ruth and so on. And outfield was my preference. Played a lot. Okay. Outfield especially, not left out, but left field, right field especially, and a little first base as well.
Okay, well, I saw the football pictures around. Did you play football too?
Yes, I did. Yes, I did, man.
Did you name two or three of these people you played with that we also know about? Any...
Okay.
Well, graduated about 73, maybe?
Proctor
70?
Boys. Butch Proctor was a couple years ahead of me. Greg Fazette was on the team. John Corcoran, who's no longer in this area. Bud Bacon.
Okay.
Point of Rush area.
Well, you were for this area. All right. Now we know for sure he was. Okay. You went away and you said that you came back. When did you get back?
I got back approximately a year ago, Bob, after living in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. That's where I relocated after college to go to work for Procter & Gamble. 8 years there, Enola, which is West Shore, separated by the Susquehanna. And then in Miami for 3 years, Kendall specifically, South Miami, and then Lauderdale for almost 3 years.
So you decided that quality of life is better than all that money you were making?
That's the bottom line, huh? In essence. Many people, that's a good way to look at it. And that's people have asked me so many times, yeah. Why Plattsburgh since I've been back? Why come back?
But it's home. Everybody wants to go home.
Family, roots,
of
home.
Of course, of course. But did you find anything you liked better than Plattsburgh along the way as far as quality of life?
I would find, and again, that at the risk of people, if that's a redundant question, the quality of life, and then when it boils down to, I find that people are, in general, much more honest and open after living in some metro areas. You do acclimate, but I find overall that's one of the biggest benefits to being back, is the honest, the sincerity, if you will, and the honesty of people. So.
Okay. The next best thing of having quality of life here is being a member of the Plattsburgh and Clinton County Chamber of Commerce. What do you have to do with them? What do you do?
Okay, specifically my title is Member Services Manager, and what that encompasses is, well, there's about four different functions specifically to not only retain our current membership, of which we have approximately 1,000 members, qualify a little further, about 85% of our membership are five or less employees, small businesses per se, varies from market to market and all, but it might be less than 100 employees. So we are a good voice. And I won't say the sole voice, but one of the major voices in the area for the small businessman. In addition, my function is to sell new members. I believe I sold my 50th new member the other day. Started October 1st, so that's going well. Another key function is recruiting volunteers for ongoing special events, St. Patty's Day breakfast next week, the trade show, Plattsburgh State Fieldhouse. Also another function is to get, as we try to look for additional ways to generate revenues, underwriting sponsorships, like for our annual dinner. And for some down the road, it would be our second, the inaugural golf tournament we had last June at Bluff Point. And those, in essence, would be my four key functions.
When I think of Chamber of Commerce, I never thought of selling it. I thought that maybe somebody would say, I think I want to join the Chamber of Commerce, make a phone call or stop in and send in my $50. And become a member of the chamber. That's not the way it's done?
I wish it was that easy, and $15, that might have been about 80 years ago.
All right.
The membership dues investment, if you
it's
will.
It's more than that, though?
It is slightly more than that.
Well, are you good at role-playing?
Sure.
All right. Let's assume that I started a new business called TV Awareness, and I go out and do all kinds of shows, and I sell these shows and so forth, and you heard about me, had to add the paper, so you want to come in and you made an appointment, you want to sell me the Chamber of Commerce. I don't belong. What would you do?
Okay. You're new in the area, Bob. Maybe you could tell me a little bit more about your company, TV Awareness.
I take weddings, I take pictures of graduations, I inventory homes, the normal thing that you do yourself, but you never get around to it. I do it, and I charge you a fee.
Okay. So it looks like a very unique service, and I'm sure doing quite well, and it's a fairly infant company.
Right.
Okay. Would there be anything in particular, Bob, that you would look for from a Chamber of Commerce in regards to a benefit of membership, if you will?
The only thing I know about Chamber of Commerce, I can go and get a leaflet to know where the tourist attractions are in the city.
Okay.
And in the county. Now, other than that, I don't know much about Chamber of Commerce.
Okay. Because we have, and you're not unlike many other people, too, in the respect they're not totally aware what the Chamber what the mission is more than to foster the economic development of the respective members comprising the chamber and as well as the community as a whole. There are many benefits that we have to membership. Matter of fact, so many benefits that it doesn't take all that long to recoup an investment for most of our members, of which is $150 annual membership dues, if you will, investment. And we think it's an investment because it's an investment to generate some new sales, and a large benefit of membership would be the networking that you can realize from our monthly business after hours, which are more than just a social get-together. The whole idea is to generate some new sales via some word-of-mouth advertising.
What is that you just told me? How do I get together?
It's something that we promote in our newsletter. It's typically the third Wednesday from 5:30 to 7, an hour and a half approximately in duration. And these are so popular that we have sponsors that put these on that typically accommodate from 75 to 100 people approximately.
Have we come here to your office?
No, the last one we had was at Clinton Community College and their wonderfully new phys ed facility. And they vary from place to place, and they're so popular. Again, we have sponsors for these events right through pretty much February of 93. The next one is April 15th in conjunction with the city, and there's going to be a different twist at the Crate Memorial Center.
We're going to take a short break here. We've got the battery or something trouble. We'll be right back to you. You're watching What's Going On Here. The show is Plattsburgh at Clinton County Chamber of Commerce. We're talking to that sportsman from Beekmantown Central School, Steve Oakley. Be right back. Battery problem solved. We're back at the chamber, and we're talking to Steve Oakley, and he's trying to sell me a membership here, and I guess we'll get away from that. And I guess I get down to the final. What would it cost me as a small business with just one employee and myself to belong to the chamber?
One employee, and that, again, is the bulk of our membership, chamber membership of approximately 1,000 members. It comprises companies like yourself, Bob, in essence, 1 to 5, 1 to 7 employees. And that one-year, one-time investment is $150. And if you're a new member coming into the fold, there's a one-time initial processing administrative fee, if you will, of $15. It's an investment. We look at it in regards, even though we're not for profit, as a promotional or an advertising type of budget, because what with our membership directory and the newsletter, there's many means, modes to advertise your business and create an awareness out in the marketplace in this area.
It appears to me, I'm not going to tell you whether I'm joining or not, because that was a fictitious business. It would appear to me with 1,000 members, you must be pretty well covered in various business places. There aren't too many suspects or prospects left.
Amazing you'd mention that, because the highest I'd heard after going to a management conference, New York State Chamber of Commerce, about a month and a half ago with my cohort, Colleen Pope, was that 69%, if you will, account penetration for the Cleveland area Chamber of Commerce. We're approximately 50. From my understanding, when I started here, before I started here initially, that Amy Whitehead had mentioned, we have approximately 2,000 suspects versus qualified prospects in Clinton County, of which we had about 1,000 members. We do have members, if you will, across the lake, so I'd like to say my Oceanside view, and we have some from Essex County as well as the Montreal area too, from those market areas, but most of our members are comprised from Clinton County.
I'm glad you mentioned suspect, because when I was selling years ago with Dun & Bradstreet, they told me all the prospects I had, and nearly half of the prospects were only suspects. We make them into prospects along the way. All right. What is your normal day like, Steve? What would you do in a day like today? You got enough numbers on this phone here, all kinds of stations here.
It's, if you will, it's an ever-changing, there's not a typical day, and as we reorganize a little bit, my major thrust and my forte will be out interfacing with prospects in the marketplace. When I'm inside, before we have met today, a lot of my time was being spent in regards to retaining our membership, i.e. addressing renewals of memberships. There's a lot of phone time. It's a very valuable sales tool. There's always something going on and mid-course adjustments to be made because of our special events and things to be done. That it changes periodically.
Are you involved in this very much?
I will be in the booth that day for the duration from 11 to 7.
Okay.
And, certainly looking forward to it.
So that in addition to the you're being looking for new members, you're servicing the older members,
exactly.
You said, right?
Exactly.
Make sure they're happy so that when it comes time for renewal, while they continue to be a member, there'll be a reason because you haven't just forgotten them during the year.
Exactly.
Okay.
And we are here to serve them, and any way we can better serve them, everyone's a valued member, and the whole equals the sum of its parts here at the Chamber. And everyone's very important, and that's going to be a real big issue in the 90s, not just our chamber, but many other chambers, is the retention of our current membership.
Okay. Expo 92, March 18th, 1990, at the SUNY Fieldhouse, sponsored by WPTZ, the Plattsburgh Office Systems, Durham's Exchange, Press Republican, and, of course, the Plattsburgh-Clinton County Chamber of Commerce. Anything else you want to tell us about your job or about the chamber? And you're part of it?
I would say, and what comes to mind, is that it's not a very easy job to stagnate in. There's always something different. It's ever-changing, and like I mentioned just a little bit ago, very much mid-course adjustments, so that makes it always a challenge. The good people to work with, it is a people business, of course, and we have a very good staff here to work with. It gets a little hectic at times, but we seem to get through it, and it's really a team effort.
Well, because of all the changing seasons we have up here, and they're quite different, is there any better time of the year to sell than not sell?
Any time's
a good time to sell. Look at that nice picture on the wall to your left, Calvin. One of the great reasons for being up in our county in northern New York, right there, the changing color of the leaves that people come from miles and miles around, right?
Don't get too many maple trees or maple leaves down in South Florida. And, of course, there were four seasons in South Florida, too, hot, hotter, hottest, and just right. Just right was too short. And the winters, like I've heard many people say, used to be a lot more severe, be it 20 years ago.
They sure are. It was relatively easy this year, although we're going to get some snow tonight. We're talking with Steve Oakley and you people in Beekmantown who may or may not be seeing this. If you are, remember this face, that smiling face with the baseball, the football, and all of the good times back in the 70s, right?
Back in the early 70s. Seems like yesterday.
Okay. Thank you very much for talking with us, Steve. I'll let you get out and do some of the things you'd like to do right now as soon as we leave. Thank you very much,
Bob.
Okay, right. Steve Oakley, Plattsburgh, and Clinton County Chamber of Commerce. Please stay tuned. We're going to be talking with other people here at the Chamber. I've been promoted. I'm the one behind the desk. And my guest right now is Colleen Pope. Did I say that right?
Yep, sure.
Colleen Pope. All right. This is really her desk, but because we want her facing you people out there who are watching this on TV. Colleen, what is your title, if any? You've got to have a title.
I certainly have a title.
What is your
title? I'm the communication manager here at the Chamber.
With the outside or within the office, or what does that mean?
Both internal and external communication. I write the newsletter. I make press releases. I design brochures. We just redid this. This is the new newsletter.
Right, you designed this as you put it together?
Mm-hmm.
By computer?
Mm-hmm.
That's what it's all about. See, the Chamber Vision. The editor, Colleen, Colleen Pope. And I guess I'm going to have to ask you, there aren't many popes in the city of Plattsburgh, so are you related to a guy named Nicholas?
Yeah, that's my dad.
That's your dad. He's pretty well known in this area, isn't he? Wasn't he with the Chamber at one time?
Mm-hmm. 73, 74. I think he was the president of the Chamber.
He was president of the Chamber of Commerce. Yes, and very active. And we've seen his picture in the paper, and we've seen many things that he's involved in. Mm-hmm. How long have you been with the Chamber here?
Since October.
Oh, you just started, too.
I just started.
Together. You're twins.
We're attached.
You and Steve.
You're at the hip.
And you're right, joining offices. What were you doing before that?
I just finished graduate school. I got my master's degree from Syracuse University, and I finished that beginning of September, end of August, and came here in October.
And in advertising, what was your...
My master's is in public relations. My undergraduate was in communication arts.
Okay.
In French.
Is this a new position at the Chamber?
The Chamber went through some restructuring, and it is a new position that was created through the restructuring. It used to be the tourist position, director of tourism, but that's no longer, it's been phased out. Now we all deal with tourism, and I'm specifically in charge of the communication for the office.
Okay, you have two computers. Yeah. You use both of these?
Yep, I sure do. This is my own computer. This is my Macintosh. This is what I lay the...
You did this on this here?
Mm-hmm.
How could you do this big thing on that little tiny screen?
You blow it up after.
All right. And these are your own ideas that you do it here each time?
Well, we follow
at least the format. You follow, right?
I always have the two main articles.
Right.
The month at a glance. That way, even if people don't even open the newsletter, they have everything that we're doing for the month right on the front page.
And this goes to all members? Is that the idea?
This goes to all members plus. The circulation on this is a little over 1,200.
Are they out in public places at all?
Not really.
Not really. Okay. No. And this is the March issue. Tells what's coming up and what has happened, right? And the whole story. Very nice. Come for breakfast. March the 7th.
Congressman Martin breakfast.
Yes, just saw that picture in the paper just recently on that. All right, so what else? Do you have to leave the office for your job at all?
Oh, I sure. Quite a few times. I deal with printers on a daily basis. I'm always going, dealing with printers, working with layout, working with mechanicals, and doing the...
Okay, so this was done by a printer.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, I lay it out. I give them the camera-ready copy, and then we work from there.
Okay. You do the camera-ready copy here?
No, actually, my computer isn't hooked up to a laser printer, so I take the disc and I print it out at their printer.
Okay. All right, so tell us a little bit more about your job.
I designed quite a few things. We designed the annual report for this year, which is a bit different.
I just saw that on the wall up there. Now, is this an actual picture of the old Plattsburgh Bee?
Yes, it is. It's 1924, if you can believe it.
You might look at that one, Calvin. It might be better because this one here has been folded. We could talk about this one here, but this obviously is looking south,
bay.
Right? That's the bay.
Yep.
And the old beach. And I guess they had an unusual parking lot here. There must have been something going on that day. That wasn't normal, I wouldn't think.
Just a hot summer day.
Yeah. Beautiful picture.
On the other side is our calendar, or is our annual report.
Okay.
So that way people won't just toss it out.
Okay, let me hold this up here. This, so you don't just toss it out. It keeps the vision continues and what they expect for 1991. And there's the staff right there. Six people, seven. We were told she had six employees, Amy Whitehead had six.
That's seven. This is Shirley. She's a part-time secretary in the afternoon, receptionist.
Okay, we're going to try to talk to most of those people. The board of directors are up here. You can't possibly see them all. We notice Mike Mannix very prominent in the front row. And so you said we when you did this. Is this something that you've learned? You never say I, but you do most of this yourself?
Well, everything in this office is a group effort, pretty much.
It is. All right.
I work very closely with Amy, very closely with Robin, Steve. You don't ever do anything on your own here. Everyone's always helping.
Okay. So you're developing the advertising I just put in my pocket. This was done by you also?
No, this actually we freelanced out to a graphic designer.
Uh-huh.
She did that. But I'm in charge. If I don't have time to design everything myself, I'll freelance it out. I'll farm it out to somebody else who does have time to do it or who might want the work.
Okay. So I don't know much about communications. I guess, is there anything you do besides the communication? Sometimes you do a lot more than what your title is called, right?
All
right? What else do you do with the chamber?
I'm very involved with the Small Business Committee. Small Business Task Force just finished. As Steve might have told you, our membership is comprised of 85% small business owners with less than 10 employees.
Right.
So that's a very, very important aspect of the chamber business. And the Small Business Task Force was a short-term committee that was established to decide what the Small Business Committee should do. They're making the recommendation to the board this month at the March 18th board meeting.
Is that yours?
Nope, that's fine. Someone will get it.
Okay, someone else is going to get it. We're talking.
If the recommendation is approved, we'll have a standing small business committee with certain people to create seminars and workshops throughout the year. Certain people will investigate a different insurance carrier, all different kind of matters that affect small business owners. The chamber does quite a bit for small business, and whether people don't really know that yet. We have quite a few benefits for small businesses. As you know, we have an extensive insurance program.
I heard about it, but I don't know which one's going to tell me about it.
Suzanne will probably tell you more
about
it.
All right, okay.
But it certainly affects the small business owner because through us, the small business owner can get insurance for his or her employees.
Is that health or life or both?
Health insurance.
Health insurance.
We have both.
Very, very important today.
Very important. We also are going with a new long-distance service carrier. It's a benefit for small businesses or even big businesses. It's another benefit of the chamber. By going through us to get your long-distance service, there's a, I believe it's almost a 40% discount on long-distance, and that's
40%? You can't kick about that, can you?
It's quite a bit.
Absolutely.
So, we also hold many seminars and workshops throughout the year to help small business owners. We co-sponsor numerous workshops over the course of the year with the Small Business Council and the Small Business Association in Albany. We do a lot of stuff with small business. It's very important.
Okay. If a phone rang like that, person calling for the very first time, got a question about, I don't have any idea what, your operator would give it to the right person, each in your own field, whatever?
Yes. Normally, Peggy and Shirley answer the phones, but there's four lines, and there's only two of them. We all jump in. Even Amy jumps in and answers the phone if it rings. We try to get it on the third or fourth ring. Doesn't always happen, but we do. We have a policy to try to. So Amy or I is just as likely to pick up the phone as Peggy or Shirley would. So.
Okay. Why would you have a second computer?
The other computer is, this is logged onto the network, and I can, this office is IBM, or IBM compatible, with lined up with a through network, and this I can get to all these different programs and then print them out.
Okay.
Different things. So, but this isn't attached to the network. This is my own computer.
Your personal computer?
Mm-hmm. I had it in college.
Okay. Macintosh, I see. All right, what else? Are you in anything else here that you do primarily? I realize you all
work on
everything, but and that's assigned by Amy? Is she the one that would decide it? Or is it Robin that does that?
Amy and Robin. Well, Amy, most things come down from Amy, but Robin is the associate director, and we help. She is basically plans the programs. But now, every program we have has certain aspects to it. It's got to be sold. It's got to be organized. It's got to be sold to the members, and then it has to be promoted. So Robin may organize it. Steve may pump it to the members, and I may design the communication pieces for it.
There's the program. I hope the name's not of the members not in here is going to be the Irishman of the Year. Okay, because you're going to hand these out. As your host, the board of directors, chamber staff, and then the past Irishman of the Year. 34th annual, I can't believe that many, but very first one, Edward Joe Barnstein, 1959. I was born in 1958. I was a very small child at the time. We're talking with Colleen Pope, and she's with communications and many other things. And we came in here, we were going to talk to the associate director, Robin Albert, is that correct? And we found out that Colleen was leaving the building, and can you tell us where you were going? Were you going out to lunch for 11:30, or was this a business call?
This wasn't a business call. I was going to buy tickets for the hockey game this weekend.
Oh! Okay, can you still get them?
I just called earlier, and there are some left, yes.
Now, will the chamber be involved at all with this big weekend? Are you doing anything about that at all? You don't know it far enough ahead to be able to promote it at all, right?
We don't. That's done mainly through SUNY Plattsburgh.
But still, that's an awful lot of good advertising that you can put in about
Plattsburgh. We'll probably get quite a few calls on hotels and different things to do while people come for the hockey game.
So they do call a chamber of commerce about the hotel?
We get so many calls here.
Like, for instance?
Oh, people call for everything under the sun, from hotel and restaurants to they want to know what the calendar of events for the summer are. They want to know
what time the movie open.
We get calls for
do
that.
Do you?
We get calls for what's the phone number for the post office. We get calls for everything here, and we're always happy to try to answer. People call up, and even just today I got a crazy question. Says, you don't know who might be in charge of the Celtic Club of Plattsburgh, but we have a Peggy's Little Black Book. Go through it. It's got almost everything you could possibly want to know in it.
Have you ever had a call that said, who are Bob Van and Calvin Castine from Hometown Cable? You ever had a call that said that?
Never had. Not yet.
Did you know who we were before we came in?
No.
Have you ever seen our show on TV when it was here in the city? Channel 10 or 29?
I watch TV maybe. I get to watch CNN maybe about 10 minutes a day.
You don't watch TV a lot, huh?
I couldn't even tell you what the most popular television show on TV is right now.
Well, you got two screens here, but they're for a different basis, huh?
I'm so busy, I just don't ever watch TV.
It's very nice to be busy like that.
That's great. Keeps me busy.
That's great. Okay, well, we wish you the very best of luck. You've got a nice little office right here in the Plattsburgh and Clinton County Chamber of Commerce. The communications officer, I believe she was called, and it's Colleen Pope. And thank you very much for talking to us, Colleen. And hope you get your tickets.
No, I do too.
We're in another office on the outside. It says, my other office has a window, because this one doesn't. But she smiles anyway. Her name is?
Robin Albert.
All right, and you are the associate.
That's correct.
Now, that used to call that the assistant director. They don't call assistant anymore, right? It's associate now.
Associate, assistant, okay. Probably one in the same.
We used to have assistant pastors in our church, and now they're all associate pastors. I said, what does that mean? You know, the, all right. How long have you been with the chamber?
I've been on staff about a year and a half, just a little over.
Okay. Mm-hmm. From Plattsburgh area?
I'm from Elizabethtown.
You were from Elizabethtown? You raised Elizabethtown?
Mm-hmm.
Well, now, I thought, we're looking at all these pretty pictures here. You mentioned your dad in Wyoming, I thought.
My dad lives in Wyoming. He just moved there about a year
ago. Oh, right. Elizabethtown, New York.
Right.
Robert Hubert Levine.
That's
Sheriff.
Right. You Sheriff. Got it.
Oh, yes.
He's still
and,
there.
And the four daughters and Shirley. Yeah, the Levines. All right, so you're from Elizabethtown. We'll talk about that off camera, I
okay.
guess. All right.
Sounds good.
What were you doing before you came here, Robin?
I was working out of the chamber office. How far back would you like me to go?
Well, after a year and a half ago. A year and a half ago.
Right before that, I was working on out of the chamber office on two subcontract projects. One of them was the Beekmantown Welcome Center. I started that up for Governor Cuomo's coming in dedication. And
you mean the one on 87?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
What do you mean you started it up?
Doing a lot of things that I do here as far as it was more or less a big project to get brochures in, get some advertising done, ordering equipment, workers in there to build shelves, that type of thing.
We thought of doing a story on that building because if people locally don't stop in, that's a beautiful building.
Oh, it is.
It's a great operation.
It is beautiful.
I was thrilled when I went in. I was amazed. Is it open year-round?
Mm-hmm.
It is, though. Okay.
They cut the hours back in the wintertime, but it's open year-round.
But it is open. All right. Now, that was one of the things you did. So you've been in this type of field before, even before you came?
More or less. That was probably my inception as far as starting in this type of field. Somebody
okay.
left on staff, and I became the projects and communications director. And then in November, got an upgrade to associate director.
What does that mean? What does an associate director do except everything?
Well, I'm in charge of a lot of, it's mostly projects. From my position, projects and communications manager before, it hasn't changed a whole lot. There is more responsibility to become more actively involved in community events, community activities. My job falls under the Community Development Division. I work with Amy quite a bit. She informs me of various committees that she's involved in. Once in a while, when she can't make it, I come in her place as a representative from the chamber. A lot of contacts that I have made through this job with various community people.
Okay, now, in behind me here, I see a chart that I guess has to do with the Expo 92.
That's correct.
That is taking place on the 18th of March, and you're watching this after the 18th of March. But did you line these up like this yourself?
We did. Usually the floor plan doesn't change a whole lot from year to year. Every once in a while the committee has changed it just so it works for exhibitors. But it's basically been that same layout.
Okay, by the time we see this, as we mentioned, it's going to be after the 18th. We also will not be St. Patty's breakfast has already gone by this, the Irishman of the Year. What can we talk about that takes place that still isn't up yet, that will start April 1st on, say, that you have planned? Anything?
For the springtime, most of my projects take place in the fall and in the spring. For the springtime, which after the show and then after St. Patrick's Day, will be the Chamber's having their 80th anniversary this year. We'll be having Office Olympics, which will probably be the first or second week of May, and along with that, a cocktail reception for chamber members for the 80th anniversary.
Office Olympics?
Office Olympics.
What's that mean?
We haven't yet decided what we're going to do. It's basically more or less a fun kick off your shoes.
Oh.
Have fun day. We thought of various games to do with office supplies, office equipment. Hopefully the weather will be nice. We can do something
outside. And that'll be for the general?
That'll be for the chamber members.
Okay.
I hope you'll include waste paper basketball.
You've got it. You've got it.
There you are. Right. You got all these big brown bags around the community with
this
amazing paper and recycling.
That's right.
Does the chamber get involved in recycling at all?
Yes, we do.
What do you promote it? What do you do?
We recycle our office paper. I wouldn't say that we promote it. Champlain Valley Industries is a member, and we are part of their recycling program. They come once a week, like they do, I'm sure, at various businesses, and it works out well. I think we are definitely conscious of it as a staff, and I'm more conscious of it at home for sure.
So a lot of your time is outside this office. You actually make, well, yeah, we know a few minutes ago you were gone. We were going to talk to you. You were already out. You were in and out already this morning with us, and it's
and
a little,
I'm back.
Well, just before noon now. Yeah, you'll be leaving again for lunch pretty soon.
There are quite a few committees that I'm involved in that are right here in the chamber. There are some outside committees that I've just recently become involved in, one for the city of Plattsburgh for the Mayor's Cup. I would say I spend most of my time in the office. It depends on the project. It depends on what time of year it is.
Now, the Mayor's Cup, that's a big event that you're involved in very much, right, as a chamber?
We're slowly starting to get involved.
You haven't been involved that much
Actively,
previously?
Actively not in the past, unfortunately, but that will change.
Okay.
We will definitely become
Do you have a booth out anywhere? In the city, any brochures are picked up here.
Right.
You have nothing at the city beach as such where there's a lot of tourists coming in?
We have a new sign that is just across the street right before GP noting tourist information to stop here. And we have it busy year-round, but definitely mostly in the summertime.
All right, well, let me ask you something that maybe there's a reason I shouldn't ask this, but I don't know any better. Why wouldn't you have a booth right at the entrance of the beach where you could promote all of your members to people that don't even get this far into the city, maybe?
We used to, but the problem is with staffing. We just don't have anybody full-time
right.
to staff the booth out there. It would be wonderful. I
you
mean,
couldn't
it would be
get
ideal.
Volunteers for that, you don't think?
We tried it, and it didn't work.
It didn't work out.
Somebody who is as knowledgeable as the staff is to distribute those
Well, I guess what you have to do is you have to go to that class of people, that group of people who are, if you pardon the expression, passe a little bit, those senior citizens. Have you ever talked to those people? They're the ones who do it up in the northern tier.
Mm-hmm.
They're glad to do it.
Mm-hmm.
They're glad to use it. And they were the ones that, I would think that you would need something. When people go to the beach, then they're going to get on back onto the 87, and
sure.
they're going to go south, and they're never going to go by your office.
Mm-hmm.
And I would think that there's a logical place, and maybe one out near I know it takes personnel, but I would think if I were coming in this area as a tourist, I would look around the mall somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
To see if there wasn't someplace I could get information.
Mm-hmm. The malls do have their own tourist information customer service center. They don't have a lot of the brochures. We do, of course. It would be a great idea,
right.
but like I had mentioned before, it is the volunteers.
Okay.
Maybe in the future we will get some people who would be willing to do that. It is a big responsibility.
Yes, it is. Now, I noticed when I came in, I saw probably 60 or 80 brochures as I come in here, all free of charge.
Right.
You don't print those, do you?
No. Some of them we do, but mostly, as far as the attractions are concerned, it's from those various attractions, amusements, so
and they
and
bring
so
them
forth.
In to you.
That's correct.
Now, if they are not members, do they have to pay you to distribute those?
No.
They don't give you a donation or nothing?
Most of them are members, but because we are a tourist information center also, we do have some out there that are not chamber members. Because we have so many requests for them,
okay.
we can't normally turn them down.
Okay. Let me ask you a real broad question. I don't like broad questions, but here's one. What's the biggest problem for a chamber? What do you say is your major problem? I know that's an awful big question, but it gives you a chance to go in any direction you want. What's the chamber's biggest problem?
I would say, knowing from this chamber and my experience here, is that we are understaffed, and maybe this is going off in too far of a negative direction, but we're understaffed, and I don't feel right now we can serve the members as well as we could. We're doing the best job that we can right now, but because we don't have extra staff people. I believe that's a hindrance to our
okay.
service.
If you wanted to have more staff members, you'd have to have more money. There's only one way to get money. Is that by having more membership? You get any
yes.
grants from anybody? Any from the county? Any from the city?
Partly county funded, but not enough so that it would offset another staff member.
Right. And to make sure that no one out there misunderstands, there is, because it's called Clinton County Chamber of Commerce, it is not a county organization whatsoever. right? It has nothing to do with the county government whatsoever. You may get a little assistance to advertise Plattsburgh in the area. All right. What's the most fulfilling part of the job as far as you're concerned?
Oh, definitely the people, no doubt. Making the contacts, working with different people, no day is the same as the day before or the next day. It's as far as from routine as you can get. I really enjoy that.
I think I could have gathered that if you didn't say anything, as long as you had the same facial expressions while you were telling me that. You really do enjoy that,
oh,
right?
Oh, I do. I really do.
And do you get much contact with the people who use the surfaces in a sense of, I think of tourists. Whenever I think of a Chamber of Commerce, I think of tourists coming in. But it's not only tourists, right?
Oh, no.
I should know where to go. May I look at this book right there that's sitting right here?
Sure.
For instance,
sure.
I saw this in another office. It says Chamber of Commerce, 1992, Membership Directory and Buyer's Guide. Now, I hope this only doesn't go to other members.
It does go to other members. It is available for people who are non-members or people who are considering membership in the chamber.
All right, because if I'm a member, I probably would know this anyway, a lot of it. But as a non-member, what a great directory for me as an individual.
Oh, it's
Now, do I have to buy that if I wanted one of those?
It is $20 for non-members and $5 if members would like additional copies.
Okay, this is all broke down in here by all kinds of, I guess, alphabetical order, arts, crafts, apartment rentals, individual professionals, groceries, supermarkets, and so forth. It's the Bible, so forth. It's the yellow pages on white paper,
sure,
for the area, right?
That's right.
And
that's
it gives you addresses and the owner's name, the whole works. If you don't have one of these and you want to know what's going on in your community, and I'm not here to advertise, but I think you should have something like this. It's called the Membership Directory and Buyer's Guide. And this is one of the advantages of being a member. Your name is in here, right?
That's right.
And if you know what it costs to advertise in Yellow Pages, of course, that goes out to the general public. This does it. Is this available in the library or anything like that?
No.
All right. Let me ask, why not? Why wouldn't one of these be in the public library? You ever think of it?
I don't know if we have, but it's a good consideration.
Certainly should be in the public library.
Sure.
Should be one in one of the county buildings downtown, I would think,
mm-hmm,
where people could go in and who don't necessarily buy one may want to look up something.
Mm-hmm.
And if they're looking up something, somebody in here is going to get advantage of their looking it up. They're going to go buy something.
Right.
Because they aren't looking at it for the pictures. There aren't any.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Very good. That's just another little thing. I don't want to tell them how to run. What is this? Why is this here? What's this guy's name?
That's a friend. I don't know what his name is.
Don't have a name yet.
Doesn't have a name yet.
Okay, well, he looks very cute sitting up there. All right. What else can I cover now? Many of the things I would probably ask you, I probably have already talked to with Amy, and I think we were off camera at the beginning, and I asked you what's the difference between your job as associate and hers as director, and I joked about it, but whatever, she doesn't do, you're next in line to do it. Is that basically correct?
That's about as close as you can get, yes. We do work closely together and have more so since I have become associate director just a few months ago. Like I said, representing her at meetings she can't attend or duly representing them. I wouldn't want to say that she passes things on to me. She clearly identifies what the responsibilities are. We work closely together.
Very good. Anything else you want to tell me about the chamber?
I would recommend that businesses who aren't chamber members that to come in and speak with myself, Steve Oakley, Amy, any member of any company who is looking to become a member of the chamber. And if there are any members out there who believe any kind of services that we aren't providing at this time, to come speak with one of us.
Okay, now this is a good salesman you just heard. She didn't say come in and become a member, because they're not asking you or begging you to become a member. They're saying, come in and find out what you offer, right?
That's right.
All they want is a chance to explain to you, and once you know it, I'm sure you'll become a member, but don't be afraid to come in just because I said that, right?
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome, and it was nice talking to Mrs. Albert?
Miss.
Miss Albert from Elizabethtown, New York, or I should say Plattsburgh, by way of Elizabethtown, New York. Essex County, no less. Thank you very much. I love your pictures.
Thank you.
You can tell she likes those mountains. Look at.
Oh, yes.
Here, and a beautiful shot up there. It looks a lot like the Bouquet River. That's the Bouquet down through.
I don't think so. I think the mountains are
a little bit high for your area down there,
yeah.
Huh? Looks like going in around Wadhams or something, except the mountains are too high. Thanks very much. And then when we don't see that, you see lakes, you see boats. around here. And we're at the Plattsburgh and Clinton County Chamber of Commerce. The show is called What's Going On Here? Thank you for watching. We hope you will continue to watch, and you'll forgive my voice this morning. I am really having trouble breathing. But it's a pleasure to be here because of the smiling faces that we have right here. Thank you very much, Robin.
Thank you.
Oh, by the way, we're into where the money is now. Not only did I see some on the desk, see, but this is the lady, I understand, that pays the bills and can tell us all about the insurance. She does the bookkeeping. And her name is?
Suzanne Neforos.
All right. Now, Neforos, we got to ask, I guess that's a popular name around the community we know about. In the restaurant business, is that the Gus you married into the family?
Yeah, my father-in-law was Gus.
All right. Now we already feel like we know each other here. Gus has been around here for a long, long time as a place. Now, your position as Susan is what? As a bookkeeper, what does that mean?
Well, I mainly serve bookkeeper, which means I handle the regular billing and the accounts receivable and payable for the chamber, their regular operating funds, and I'm also a health insurance administrator, and I handle all of the billing and the receipts and health insurance information for any members who would like to know about what health insurance we offer to our members.
Okay. Now, you realize of everything you just told me there that people are going to be mostly interested in, obviously, is not that your job's not important, but bookkeeping, they're going to say, you know, it's the same, a different name on the top, you're paying bills, you get money in, you operate a computer. But insurance, now, I'm not too sure I understand this. You sell insurance?
We administer insurance plans for both Blue Shield of Northeastern New York out of Albany and Community Health Plan, which is located, it's also out of Albany, but they're local offices are on Margaret Street where the Grand Union used to be.
Okay, and this is only available to employees here and to anybody who is a chamber member?
Every company who is a member of the Chamber of Commerce, their employees are eligible to receive these insurance benefits. So the individual doesn't have to be the member, just a company that they're employed for, like all of our benefits at the chamber, every employee of a member is eligible.
All right. Susan, two people told me that 85% of the people who belong to the, or the companies that belong to the chamber, have under 10 employees. Mm-hmm. So that when that person joins for ABC company, it's one member, or is it 11 members because he's got 10 employees? Are there 11? Did that count as 11 of the 1,000 members or only one? Is it a company that joins, or is it individual?
It's a company that joins. The chamber doesn't offer individual memberships. We only offer for businesses.
All right. Now, do they have to pay a bigger membership if he has people in with him? Or are I'm a little confused here, because those 10 members can get insurance through the company. The company buys the insurance for the employees, or the employees buy the insurance?
It doesn't make any difference to us who pays it. The owner can pay it, or the employer can pay it, or he can make arrangements to take it out of his employee's check, or his employees can send us the payment.
Is this a group rate type of a thing, too?
Yes, it is. We have different rates for Blue Shield, one based on companies that have more than 4 subscribers. Companies that have less than 4 subscribers are at a substantially higher rate than the other group.
All right. If I were an employee of a company and they do not have insurance, and I were watching this TV program right now, I would ask my boss if he's a member of the Chamber of Commerce here in the Plattsburgh Clinton County group. Now, I'm not going to ask him to buy my insurance. I could buy it, pay all the rates myself, but through his company. Is that right?
Okay.
It wouldn't necessarily cost him money at all, as long as he's a member of the chamber, which is an advantage in itself. So if you don't have company insurance, you could get company type insurance if your employer is a member of the Chamber of Commerce, Plattsburgh and Clinton County. Is that basically
that's
right?
That's it. You're eligible to receive the benefit of insurance if your employer is a member of the Chamber of Commerce.
Okay. As a member of this insurance plan, is it likely to be less expensive than if you bought an individual?
I've talked to people who have checked. I don't know firsthand.
Okay, surely.
And they said that They have checked with the various insurance companies, and that for the same coverage that we offer, yes, it would be a little bit higher to go directly.
All right, okay. And I don't expect you, you're not a short salesman, but I will take your limited answer for what it is. And anything I ask you, if you don't know exactly, I appreciate you telling me that you are not sure. All right. They would pay you directly here, or do they pay the insurance company?
We bill quarterly. The people who get the insurance have the option of paying monthly payments or paying quarterly payments, always before the due date of the insurance. And they pay us here, and we then send the payments to either Blue Shield or CHP, whichever the person is using for their insurance.
And if anybody out there doesn't have it, they would call and ask for you? Ask for
Susan?
To get more information, right?
Yes.
Okay. Anything else you want to tell me about your insurance plan? Without giving me the whole
spiel.
Well,
you know, we offer Care Plus and Blue Shield, which in a nutshell is the $100 deductible on major medical and the $240 deductible on hospitalization. Now on CHP, there's no major medical deductible, but you do need to see their physicians there to be referred to anybody for specialist problems, and they do have a $240 hospitalization, so both are pretty well comparable. And if anybody needs to talk about it, they can call me. I can send the information to them. Or if they're not a member, they need to contact Steve Oakley, our member services director, first, and then he'll direct them to me.
Telephone number here is
563-1000.
That's easy to remember. 563-1000. And you don't have to say about call the chamber or any of these other expressions they use here where they use call home or anything else. You don't have to do that.
No.
You just call 563-1000. All right. I should have asked you this before, I guess, but are you a native of Plattsburgh, Susan?
Well, I've been here more than half my life, so I guess I am.
More than half your life, all right? Well, that means you were somewhere else. Are you from the area?
I'm from New Jersey originally, but we moved up here when I was a teenager, and I grew up in Saranac.
In Saranac. So you know a lot of people through school up through here. Okay. Anything else you want to tell me in general about your job? I appreciate you taking the time to talk to us. Right during the lunch break here.
That's okay.
All right.
Lunches are pretty flexible here. They have to be. There's a lot of paperwork in this position. So, you know, I try to return calls, and sometimes that gets
anybody else work with you directly with the bookkeeping? You do it all yourself?
Yes, I do.
And how long have you been here?
8 months.
Okay. The previous person here, they got somewhere else in the building?
She left the area.
Left the area. Okay. And thank you very much for talking to us. Susan DeForest?
Right.
All right. And you see her on the street, or you're stopping here? Tell her she has a nice smile, and thank you for talking to us on Hometown Cable, Plattsburgh and Clinton County Chamber of Commerce. What's going on here? Calvin Kastein with the camera. Bob Zed here saying thanks for watching. Every day, programs are on at 1:15, 4:30, 8 p.m., midnight, and 8 the following morning, except this past weekend when it was on 24 hours in a row. Thanks for watching. As we move around the chamber, we come to the person we should have used, people at the desk or here, or when you call, you don't ever give your name, I suppose, on the phone. You say, do you? All right, what would you say if I said, hello, your name is?
Good morning, Chamber of Commerce. Peggy speaking.
Peggy, all right. But I would ask you here, Peggy who?
Peggy Ayotte.
All right. How long have you been here, Peggy?
About 1 year now.
All right. Now, have you answered phones before you came here?
Yes.
You have, right?
Yes.
You need a certain kind of person on a phone, someone that likes to talk on the phone or on TV. Now, are you that kind of person?
Not really, but I do like to talk.
Now,
I like to help people.
Be honest. You're glad we're here taking your picture?
No.
All right. A lot of people aren't. All right. We are going to be here just a short time. We're right in the middle of her lunch period, and I think she's hungry, too. So tell us what you do. The phone rings, and then what do they usually want?
Oh, gosh, about 75% are tourists wanting to know where to go, what to do, especially on a rainy day. They want to know what's available for them. There are opportunities that I don't even think that people around here realize are out there. We do have a brochure coming out of 101 things to do in Clinton County, and actually we ended up with quite a few more than 101. So we're kind of excited about
Okay, for local people who'll be watching this mostly, where would they get that brochure to see what there is to do? They don't want to stop it here. They could stop it here. Will it be out at the 87 Welcome?
Yes, it should.
It will be. Mm-hmm. Okay.
It should be printed and back to us somewhere in April.
Okay, when you get that question, what do I do today because it's raining, do you answer that or do you refer to somebody else?
I try and answer that.
You do.
I try and give them options to do. It depends on whether they have small children. It depends on whether they're just a couple. It depends on whether they like going through museums or if they just want to kick back.
So you ask questions as well as give answers. You gotta,
yes, I do.
You have to find out what the person is interested in, right?
Yes.
Well, now you see, you do an awful lot on this phone, right? You do a lot
it
of.
It takes a lot of time.
I think Amy mentioned to us when we first came in, they had as many as 14,000 phone calls last year.
Oh, seemed like more.
It seems like more than that,
yes.
Even.
Well, we have quite a few events, too, so we end up answering the phone to make reservations.
My wife likes the phone. She likes to talk on the phone. When you get home at night, do you use the phone very much?
I don't go near the phone.
I'll bet, huh? Do you have any other responsibility, paper writing or anything like that you do here?
I do the computer work as far as customer entries, event entries, that sort of
thing. Isn't that very difficult to do when the phone interrupts you right in the middle
yes,
of your train of thought? It's got to be one of the most frustrating parts of your job.
Yes.
But, of course, that is your job. But, on the other hand, when you're waiting for the phone to ring, you're doing something else, and
right.
You're concentrating. It takes a while to get back.
To try and juggle back and forth is the
okay.
hardest thing, and still keep it accurate.
All right.
Actually, we have a part-time receptionist that comes in now from 1 to 5, and she helps to grab the phone first, which has really helped.
Is that you're on your other, your computers or something
else?
Then
I'm able to do the computer.
Okay. All right. If I may take one more minute of your time. Okay, let's go right over here a second. This is your desk. A counter. And over here, Calvin can probably see, there's all kinds of brochures.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he can't. We're plugged into electricity. We can't do it. Okay, so here, the people would come in the front door. They could pick up all this literature around here.
Mm-hmm.
That is, you're distributing for various members of the chamber.
Mm-hmm.
If you pardon the expression, you could tell them where to go.
Yeah.
Isn't it fun telling people where to go? Huh?
It can be. Yes.
Do you ever get anybody on the phone that you know?
Oh, occasionally. I talked to my brother-in-law. He called up for some information, and I said, hello, how are you? And he said, who are you? Sister-in-law.
Yes, that happens. You get some people,
yes.
Right? You don't have any idea sometimes. Mm-hmm. Well, all right. Anything else you want to tell us, Peggy?
Not too much, except that it's a growing area. It's great, and I enjoy it.
You
it's,
do?
It's
okay.
The best place in the world.
Very good. Let me ask you now. Usually when someone called Peggy,
mm-hmm.
The name's really not Peggy. Usually
yeah,
Margaret.
It's Margaret.
Is it Margaret? You know, I didn't realize just a few years ago that when someone is Peggy, their name is really Margaret. I would have called them Marge or Maggie or something, but it's Peggy, huh?
Yes,
how'd
is.
That come about, do you know?
I don't know. I asked my mother that, and she just said she didn't know.
Okay, so they've been calling you Peggy since you were first.
Yes.
That's why they called you Margaret. They
it
wanted
was
to call you.
My grandmother's name, so.
Ah, you go, right?
Peggy handed down. Irish.
Okay, very good. Irish.
Which?
You may be the Irishman of the year.
I don't think so.
You going to go to the breakfast?
Irish woman of the year.
Did I say Irishman?
Yes, you
Irish
did.
Person
uh-huh.
of the year.
There you go.
You're listening to every word. You're listening to every word I'm saying. All right. Irish person of the year. Is that what we're going to say? You go to the breakfast? I'm sorry. Did you
oh,
say?
Oh, excellent. Yes.
You will go
yes.
to the breakfast, right?
It would be great this year.
You
lots of prizes to hand out.
Okay. You won't be able to go out on the 18th. You weren't at the 18th where they have your expo day.
The expo, I will be
will
there
you
will
be there also?
In the morning. Mm-hmm.
Answering the phone.
No, collecting money.
All right. Oh, you also handle money.
Well, there's going to be a seminar before that.
And then you give the money to Susan so she could keep
yes,
track of it in the
I
books.
I log it in, and then Susan puts it in the computer.
Okay. Would you like to spend another 10 minutes? Would you think
no.
we've talked? There's a phone. Thank
right,
you very much for talking to us. Peggy Ayotte.
Thank you.
Thank you. We're back where we started, back in Amy Whitehead's office, and she's been out for an hour or so out doing her thing and making all her meetings, I take it?
Oh, yes.
All right. We're back, and we're going to wrap this up now, Amy. We want to thank you, first of all, for talking with us this morning. And
thank
let us
you
talk
for taking
your
time and coming down and visiting with us.
Well, thank you. We appreciate it. We've learned something. I know I have learned something. I've learned much more than I thought I was going to today. I didn't realize that the chamber got into all of these things. And maybe it says it in the paper, but I read right by it. Mm-hmm. Maybe on the wetlands, I didn't realize it was the chamber mm-hmm. that got into that. I just read right by that, I'm sure, to get into the meat of what happened. I'm sure I did
well,
that.
Well, that's the important part, though, is getting the information out and what's going on and what's happening with it.
But it's also important that people know what the chamber does mm-hmm. with their money and how they promote the area, not mm-hmm. just themselves, not just the business people. It's for the mm-hmm. whole area.
There are a lot of things that we do like that that are outside of the area that people aren't aware of. We go to trade shows up in Montreal promoting this area for business relocation and doing business in the area. We go up to Montreal as well as other areas to promote consumer trade shows for tourists to come to this area. We do a lot of things. Our advertising dollars for the tourism program go outside of the market. So we're doing a lot of things also that aren't necessarily very visible to people living in the market. There are a lot of things going on.
All right. I read in a paper in the past 2 weeks, I'm not sure you guys had to do with it at all, but there were more people from Vermont than there were from New York State up in Montreal mm-hmm. at a trade show.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you want to talk about that?
Yeah.
They should be there.
It's true. The next show is going to be April 6th. It's the International Rendezvous, sponsored by the Montreal Board of Trade. We are right now organizing local businesses to get up there. We have sent out about 70 letters to local businesses who that would be appropriate for them to exhibit. So we have contacted them and hope that we're going to have a good showing, because those are people that we need, that we are competing with. When a Canadian is looking at moving their business or doing business across the border, they look at us, they look at Vermont. Those people are our competitors, and we need to put our best foot forward, and that's what we're trying to do. So that is another one of those efforts that we do that, again, may not be real visible to most people.
The ads on TV, mm-hmm. Victor Pod, DeLaurier, those were put out by the chamber? Were those by the chamber?
We did some of those. The ones that were promoting Tops in New York and the community image and that side of it, those were. The Jim DeLaurier ad was our ad.
Yeah,
yes.
He was very good. I mm-hmm. told Jim, I think he had yeah. one of the best there was. He was
yeah,
so natural, did an excellent
yeah.
job.
Yeah.
Outstanding job. All right. Do you advertise it at papers up in Montreal? Telling what's here
we
available?
Advertise for tourism. We are the contract agency and have been designated such by the Clinton County Legislature. And under that designation, we receive funds from New York State as well as Clinton County to promote tourism. And with those dollars, we do advertising in Montreal as well as the southern Quebec area into Ottawa as well as northern New York and Vermont, although most of those dollars do go into Canada, and that is primarily to promote tourism. You know, tourists to come to this market.
Right, and you're certainly getting them down here. You,
oh, yes.
You want to keep them coming because mm-hmm. they really haven't noticed the drop in business here, retail,
no.
that you would have thought you would have, because the Canadians have come down even more than before.
Mm-hmm. And the thing is that a lot of people are under the notion that, well, we don't have to do any advertising, they'll come here anyway. And as anyone that is in the marketing or advertising business recognizes, that while the iron's hot, you have to reinforce it and keep these people coming down here. And so we are continuing to promote and continuing to advertise in those markets. And really, at this point, would be the worst time for us to fall asleep at the switch.
Right. Okay. I was mentioning to Robin that I thought that a couple booths in more obvious places.
Mm-hmm.
But she said the problem is help to mm-hmm. command those booths.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's important that people who wouldn't stop in here might pick it up if it was
right.
somewhere else, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And because the idea is that if a person comes down here and makes four stops,
yes.
if you could get him to make one more stop, that might be his favorite of the five,
mm-hmm.
and he'd keep coming down.
Mm-hmm.
And it's you want to know what's out there, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Anything else that you can think of you want to cover?
I don't think so. I think you've got a pretty good sampling
okay.
of what the chamber is all about. There's a lot more to the chamber than even we've been able to discuss within the last bit of time. So if anyone's interested, we encourage you either, if you are a member and would like to participate, contact the chamber offices. Our numbers are 563-1000. Give us a call and talk to any of us on staff, and we will help you to determine what it is you're interested in and where you would most fit in. If you're interested in Canada, we do have Canadian Connection committees. We've got committees on community development, community image, all those type of efforts. So if you're interested at all, give us a call. And if you aren't a member, also give us a call as well, because we'd like to have you be a part of what's happening in Clinton County.
Okay. Well, you call in 563-1000. Ask the person speaking if that's Peggy. Remember, you saw her on TV? Tell her you saw her on TV and she had a nice smile. She was a little reluctant to talk at first, but she did very, very well. She doesn't like TV, she says, but tell her you liked her on TV. All right, and one more thing. You may have questions mm-hmm. that I did not think about. Either call and ask them, or better yet, ask this lady or Robin or someone else to go speak to your group, to your organization, to your group, whatever it is, and they'll tell you all about the chamber. Mm-hmm. And they are going to try to sell you a membership because they'll give you the advantages of being one, I'm sure, but they'll be glad to tell you what the chamber does and just what's happening in Clinton County.
We'll talk about a lot of issues, everything from business climate to economic development to governmental issues. We're very good at adapting to whatever the topic is that you would like to hear.
And if you give Amy enough time, she will prepare to have at least 5 minutes with a lot of preparation to be able to speak. This lady can talk off the cuff, let me tell you. She's impressed me this morning very much, and she knows what she's talking about. She's got a nice smile to go with it, and she's a great asset here in our county. We're so glad that Nebraska's loss is our gain. But it wasn't only Nebraska. Arizona, Minnesota, Iowa, right?
Oh,
but you end up in this.
All along.
All right.
Thank you so much, Bob. And pleasure. Thank you, Calvin.
Right. So from Hometown Cable, Channel 21 on your dial every day, 1:15, 4:30, 8 p.m., midnight, and 8 the following morning. Calvin on the camera, Bob Vitt here saying thanks very much for watching. And I want to tell MR in Altona that what he told me was true, and that's all I'm going to say about it.